Hey, what's up guys, Pablo Munoz here. In this video, I'm gonna show you how I can take one of my stylized material setups and turn that into a smart material all within Adobe Substance 3D Painter so that we can reuse it in other projects. All right, so here is the project of the stylized crab and it is currently half finished, but I did spend some time setting up the shell material for the legs in this case with custom mask, with custom, cool anchor points, that sort of stuff. So I want to be able to reuse some of that setup in other parts of the project or, you know, even new projects. So I want to walk you through all of that. The first thing I like to do is make sure that my layer stack is neatly organized and named properly, specifically if I'm going to reuse this material in a brand new project, maybe in a few months from now. Currently, I have a yellow color as my base, a red color with a custom mask that blends into the yellow color, and then a third folder that I set up with anchor points so I can do some manual painting. Now, since I'm planning to reuse this in other projects, I like to make sure that the effects I use are set as triplanar. This goes for any table black and white image or anything of that nature that you use to drive the effect of a mask. So for instance, this grunge texture is set to triplanar in my project so I can reuse it in other projects. That way I can adjust it and move it later on if I need to so that it fits better any other project in the future because I don't know what that project might be. Now I'm going to name this layer color variation, and this layer is making things darker, so let's just call it darker yellow. And let's go ahead and do the same thing for the layers on the red folder. This layer is making things a bit lighter, so let's go for lighter reds. And the third one here is kind of like similar actually, so maybe we can just call this one lighter reds 01 and then copy and paste this into the next layer and call it lighter reds 02. Not super creative, but it helps me remember what these layers are used for. Now, if you want to be super organized, you could also look into custom mask and look for anything in the stack of filters that is not very descriptive and change it for a custom name as well. In my case, I have this grunge concrete paint leaks on top, which is a very clear name, but it's not really telling me what this is doing for the mask. So we can call this something like extra dirt, or actually this is more like a scratch material. So maybe let's call this extra scratches. I'm also going to rename the third folder custom spots, but here is the most important part. If you have anything with custom paint layers, like what we have here, where you can just paint custom details like this, remember that this is painting this specific UV layout. So keeping this effect and reusing it in a different mesh with, you know, different UVs will look out of place. So what we need to do is just remove it all together or delete it and create a brand new paint layer to replace it. I like calling this layer paint here just to remind my future self that this is the layer that I need to use for custom painting. And the final thing would be just, let me just check the anchor point. And I think I want to call this fill layer something like custom spots mask reference. Maybe that is too long. Maybe just go for spot mask reference. And instead, let's go ahead and update the anchor point name to be spot mask. Okay, so now the boring part is done, but believe me, this is a very important step so that you can make the most out of your own assets later on. Now we're going to turn all of these layers into our very own smart material. Let's go ahead and press the shift key and select all the folders and create a brand new folder by clicking on this icon of the folder right here on the top right. Go ahead and name the folder with whatever name you want to give to your material. I'm simply gonna call mine Stylized Crab. And now all we have to do to create that smart material is to right click on the folder and select the Create Smart Material option. Give it a few seconds and now you'll see your brand new asset in your own library. So now I can literally delete everything in my layer stack, bring back all my meshes so that we visualize this as a, let's say, a brand new project. And I'm going to click and drag my custom material into the legs. And there you go, but also drag it into the body of the crab and, you know, the eyes as well. And you see how this is using values from all those settings within the material layer and the mask, of course, but applying them to each mesh differently. What's really cool about this is that we can go to the texture set settings and let's choose something different, maybe like the body. And let's also isolate it so that we can see only this mesh for now. And let's go to the layers of that smart material folder and find the layer called spots manual and the empty paint layer that we created called paint here. And now we can have some fun adding some custom details in the areas that make sense to have them for this specific mesh. How cool is that? All right, so now let me share with you something even better about smart materials. So to prove the portability of these assets, basically to ensure that, you know, whatever works in this project can also work in other projects, let's go ahead and switch to a brand new project with a completely different crab or a different asset. All right, so this guy right here is completely new project. It has nothing to do with the previous project other than the fact that, you know, it's a crab. But for practical purposes, it has different meshes, it has different UVs, it has a different bake maps. The only thing that I have done is just a couple of layers for the eyes. Now, because we saved our smart material into our library, I can access it from here and simply drag and drop it into the crab's body. That's it. How cool is that? And we can go ahead and open up the folder. You'll see that we have all the same layers. And of course, we can look for that paint here layer to create some custom bumps in here as well. Now, this is cool and all, but what if I want a completely different look for my project? Well, the cool thing is that we can definitely adjust things very easily. And we can, for instance, select our main folder and click on the magic wand here to add an effect to the entire folder. Oh, and by the way, this is a bit of a tangent, but since we're here in this effects section, I should mention that there has been a recent update with 6 really, really cool filters that you can mix and easily create stylized textures to achieve all sorts of really cool effects. So you have the anisotropic Kuwahara, the bevel smooth, which actually deals with the height information more than anything, directional distance, grayscale conversion, quantize, and stylization, which are super, super cool. And you get really awesome effects when you combine them together. But anyway, let's go back to edit this material. So from the effect list, let's go ahead and find something called gradient. Now, this effect is very cool, very simple, and it's going to look at the colors within the folder and simplify them to a gradient of 3 values. Now, you can take the position of each value and change them to add more contrast. I want to have more of a black color in those sort of flatter areas or panels of the crab shell, and the white colors more towards the crevices with maybe less of those gray mid-tones. Now, we can have some fun by changing the colors of that gradient. And this is where you can be very creative and try something completely different, completely new. I'm going to go for a dark blue for darker values, maybe a green tone around the mid values. And let's just go for a yellow or maybe like a lighter gray here for the lighter values. That's it. You can also play with how this entire gradient effect blends with the rest, but I think I'm gonna keep it simple and I'm just gonna go for overlay just to add a little bit of contrast. But if things look a little bit too dark, we can always come back and adjust the color picker and change them again. Maybe going for some more saturated, maybe lighter colors will help as well. And, you know, make things a little bit more interesting. And I know it's not really the color of a crab, but I just want to show you how much you can change things very quickly. In fact, we can create a stack of effects just to change how the original smart material looks. So we can, for instance, maybe add another filter and let's search for something like the HSL perceptive filter. And this is a very simple filter as well, but it allows you to change the hue all at once. And you can explore different color palettes, you know, play with the saturation, the lightness of the entire color palette. So if I turn these effects on and off, you'll see how much they affect the original material. All right, so hopefully that makes sense. Now, here is another awesome feature. Let's say that you're happy with the tweaks that you created in your new custom material from that original, but you want to apply those to the rest of the texture sets in your project. You could, of course, right-click the folder and copy and paste it into the other meshes, or even create a brand new smart material that includes the new effects that you did. However, the most effective way is to right-click the folder and choose the Instantiate Across Texture Sets option. This new pop-up window will appear and you can leave everything checked except the source, of course, which is in our case, the body of the crab, and just click OK. Now what's happening is that the smart material with all the changes that we've done is being propagated through the entire texture set list. So I'm just gonna go to the eyes for a second and move that instance layer below everything else that I had, just because it doesn't make sense to have it on top, but that's pretty much it. If I go back to my source, which is the body of the scrap, you'll be able to change anything in the effects that you added and see the changes in real time across all your meshes. This also goes for blending modes, so you can now visualize the material in your entire mesh and just adjust how the effects are blending with each other. At this point, you could refine the look of your textures by adding a new fill layer. You know, let me just do that and we can basically play with how it is blending with the material. So again, just my go-to blending mode just to test things out is overlay. So let's do that and let's create a black mask, add a generator, and I'm going to use curvature to target those ridges and the bumpy areas of the mesh. And actually, I think we can make those areas a little bit lighter so you can really see the effect. I'm going to first choose a bright green color, which also helps. And I think I can set the blending mode to screen, again, just to make things a little bit brighter. Let's go ahead and adjust the balance of the curvature as well. And this basically adds a bit of contrast to that mask. And of course, we can refine the color of the layer itself, so it just feels better integrated with the rest of this weird material that we're making. And to wrap this up, I'm going to name this layer something like Edge and repeat the process that I showed you before. I'm going to instantiate this layer throughout my other texture sets. And that's it. Great. Now we can also have a control layer for all those ridges and bumps with a specific color all within our project. So that's it for this video. Hopefully you can see how quick and easy it is to create a smart material and essentially repurpose all your assets and create your own library of assets. I myself have a bunch of these smart materials in my library, and it provides me a great starting point for any new project. So if you're gonna go ahead and try this out, let me know how you go, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you wanna see more of this content on Adobe Substance 3D.